Now we get into the plant eating plant part. We're feeding broccoli to a Venus flytrap. That has to be a first, right?
The Venus flytrap, the quintessential carnivorous plant. You probably already know that the Venus flytrap captures bugs, and you may have already seen videos of people feeding their plant bugs, steak, ground beef, chicken nuggets, bacon, but you've probably never seen a Venus flytrap being fed a vegan diet. Think about it, feeding a plant, plants. In this video, that's exactly what we're gonna do. I'm Jacob Farron, co-owner of Sarracenia Northwest. Now, I've been growing these plants for the past 25 years, and I gotta say, it never gets old watching these plants capture bugs. But what's really going on when a flytrap captures a bug? I mean, why do it at all? Well, bugs are actually little packets of fertilizer. Rather than getting their fertilizer through their roots like regular plants do, carnivorous plants like the Venus flytrap get their fertilizer through their leaves. This is an example of fertilizer for orchids. Its main ingredients are nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. It also has other micronutrients like copper, iron, manganese, and zinc. And these nutrients are what carnivorous plants are getting when they capture bugs. So when we refer to plant food, this is what we mean, fertilizer. Bugs are simply a source of fertilizer for the Venus flytrap and other carnivorous plants. So that begs the question, can a Venus flytrap get its fertilizer from plant-based foods? Theoretically, yes. When you think about it, when we compost food scraps, we end up with soil that is rich in nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium, just like the ingredients in here. So what's on the menu for today? Well, we have an assortment of plant-based foods. We're gonna start off with Beyond Meats. This one happens to be their breakfast sausage. They've come out with burgers and other items. I actually had it for lunch and it's really good. The protein base is pea protein from the plants. Want to make that clear. The pea plant, you know. This one is chicken, and I say chicken with quotation marks because it's not really chicken. It does have the mouthfeel of chicken. The main protein source is soy, but boy, when you sear it up, it feels like chicken. Almost tastes like chicken too, especially if you put a sauce on it like a barbecue sauce or teriyaki. We also have tofu, another soy-based food, a staple in a vegan diet. We also have garbanzo beans, happens to be my favorite, probably the only bean that we have in the cupboard right now. We also have every kid's favorite, broccoli. This one will be a fun one to feed to a Venus flytrap. We have some white rice, leftover white rice from the other night. And of course, peanut butter. Can't go without peanut butter. You know, when I was a little kid, I hated peanut butter, but I didn't learn to love peanut butter until I got to college. It became one of my staple foods in college. And finally, we have Oreo cookies. Surprisingly, Oreo cookies are considered vegan because it doesn't have any animal products. Imagine that. So I figured, why not feed it to a Venus flytrap?
Finally, it's time to start feeding the plants. We're gonna start off with the Beyond Meat sausage. I already cut up the sausage into small pieces. Some of these might not be small enough though. I think the rule of thumb is that if you think it's small enough, cut it in half again. Because sometimes I never could gauge how small to make this. Anyway, I'm gonna trigger this trap right here. And inside the trap are six trigger hairs. And I have to trigger one, at least one of the hairs twice within a 20 second time period to trigger the trap. And there we go. Woohoo! Eat up, buddy. And let's try this again. I'm gonna trigger all the traps on each plant. There we go. I'm gonna go in there and move it around just to make sure I get the right alignment so that the trap can close easier. Okay, next up is chicken with quotation marks because, my goodness, I mean, if you look at this, I don't know if you can see that. It looks like chicken. It has the fibers just like chicken when it's seared. Wow. And the mouthfeel is just like chicken. Now I'm just gonna try to tear this up. Yeah, even that might be too big. And I'm gonna take off the outer part and just get the inner part, because the outer part was seared and crusted over. All right. Maybe I didn't even need to sear it, but I mean, I had part of it for my lunch. So there was that. Oh, that's too big. All right. I gotta work on my feeding skills. Yeah, I'm sorry, buddy. We'll just move that all in there. And this one here, you can see the exoskeleton of an insect. That's the undigestible portion of the insect. It's already dead. The plant already extracted what it could and couldn't do any more. So what the plant did was reset itself so it can capture another insect or a chicken. So now this is tofu. I suspect that the plant will digest this just fine because tofu is high in water, kind of like an insect. And it is also soy-based like the chicken, but I think tofu came before the chicken. Now we have garbanzo bean, and this one will be interesting to see how a plant reacts to it or how the flytrap reacts to it. Yeah, there we go. To see if it will digest it. And I don't know, will it get gassy? We shall find out. Now we get into the plant eating plant part. Well, plant eating plant-based food. But here, we're feeding broccoli to a Venus flytrap. That has to be a first, right? Anyway, I did cook the broccoli for a few minutes, boiled it. Every kid's favorite way of cooked broccoli, right? Boiled for 15 minutes. No, I only boiled it for 5 minutes. But I cooked it to soften it, otherwise it wouldn't be quite digestible for the flytrap. You gotta make sure the food is soft. And the part sticking out, I'm just gonna clip that off. Now we got rice, and I don't need a whole lot. I just need a few grains. I hope that's enough. And hopefully the rice will stay in the trap when I remove the tweezer. Now, some of it is sticking out, and I'll just remove that part. There we go. Now we have peanut butter. All right, this is gonna be interesting. I'm not sure how to feed it to a flytrap. It's not like I've fed peanut butter to a flytrap before, but there's always a first time. And, oh yeah, there we go. This particular peanut butter, I got it from the bulk food section at the grocery store. It has no added salt, sugar, or palm oil. It's just crushed up, ground up peanuts. That's it. Now we are at the Oreo cookies, and I only have one left. Not sure who ate the others, but I'm using a larger fly trap than what I've done with the others because I just didn't know if I could get the cookies small enough for the plant. And so let's see, here we go. All right, yay. And release. Yes. You know, and I know that Oreo cookies are kind of plant-based. It doesn't have any animal products, but that doesn't mean that it's healthy or good for you. It's good for you in the sense that it's good for the morale. That's for sure. Okay. All right. Eat up, buddy. I'm done feeding the flytraps. Now, ideally, you should put them outside under sunlight. Remember, bugs are simply a source of fertilizer for the plants. They're not a source of energy. Plants get their energy from sunlight. Carnivorous plants are no exception to that. We grow all of our mother plants of Venus flytraps here outside in full sun throughout the year. Now, with that said, I did put the batch of flytraps under grow lights in a grow room that we have
The reason for that is because the footage you saw, that was actually my second take. With the first batch of plants, I did place them outside, right here in fact, and I discovered the next day that parts of the plants were eaten by mice. They chewed off the traps that had peanut butter, sausage, Oreo cookies, and I suspect that it were mice eating the plants because birds and squirrels have a tendency to rip the plants out of the soil. Mice will chew off just what they want. At least they're nice about that. That way the plants can still survive. Anyway, I got the second batch of plants under lights and we'll check up on them in 5 to 7 days. It's 48 hours after feeding the fly traps and I wanted to see if any of the traps opened up. And sure enough, the ones with the rice and garbanzo bean opened up. Now, when that happens, that means that the fly trap didn't recognize them as viable food sources. The rice might have not had enough protein or minerals to activate the digestive process of the plant. With the garbanzo bean, the flytrap literally spit it out. Oh my goodness. Maybe it did make the plant gassy. All of the other plants have closed traps, the Beyond Meat sausage, the plant chicken, peanut butter, tofu, and Oreo. Surprisingly, even the broccoli is still closed. I would have expected that one to open up early like it did with the rice. Now, because the traps are closed, that means the flytrap is in the process of digesting the contents. So we're just gonna have to wait a bit longer to examine how much of the food the plant digested. Well, it's day 11, and typically a flytrap will reopen its trap within 5 to 7 days after capturing a bug. However, when I checked up on the plants on day 7, they were still closed, except for the ones with rice and the garbanzo bean. Interestingly, the one with broccoli right here, the traps were still closed on day 7 and didn't reopen until day 10, which was yesterday. Now, the other plants have lots of blackened traps on them, like the peanut butter, the Beyond Meat sausage, the plant chicken, even the tofu had some blackened traps. And that's a very important clue. Now, what happens is when the traps turn black, it's essentially dead. The plant is still alive, but the trap itself is dead. Now, why does that happen? Typically, it's because the food item is too nutritionally dense. We see the same thing happen when we feed fly traps ground beef. You can think of it like fertilizing a plant too much. Now, remember the orchid fertilizer I showed you earlier? Imagine if you just poured the granules over the orchid soil without diluting it with any water. That will kill the orchid roots. The same thing is happening here. The food items killed off the traps. The food was just too much for the plant to process. Peanut butter and Beyond Meat also are high in fat, and carnivorous plants are not accustomed to dealing with that much fat at one time. The other interesting food is Oreo. In this plant, I triggered 3 of the traps. Now, the open traps that you see on this plant and all the other plants are traps that opened up within the past 10 days. Now, one of the traps turned completely black, but the other two, the traps are closed, but the traps look good. So that means one of two things are going on. Either the plant needs more time to process the cookie, or the sugar in the Oreo cream is acting like glue and not allowing the trap to open up. Only time will tell of what's going on here. Now the real winner is broccoli. I mean, who would have guessed? This plant right here, the traps remained closed for 10 days, and when it reopened, there wasn't much of the broccoli left. It sucked that broccoli dry. Oh my goodness, it wasn't recognizable anymore. Now, we do know that broccoli is high in calcium, magnesium, phosphorus, nitrogen, and potassium. It's nutritionally dense that way, and so perhaps that was what the plant was craving, all of those minerals. So that goes back to our original question. Can you feed a Venus flytrap a vegan diet? Well, it depends on the food item. The digestive process of the plant is geared for insects, bugs. So if you want to feed your plant something, feed it a bug. Just make sure that the bug is freshly killed, non-GMO, and organic. But if you want to feed it a vegan diet, consider cooked broccoli.
As we can see here, this plant responded very well to it. Now, I do have high hopes for beans. And one of the questions I have about the garbanzo bean was maybe it was too dry for the plant. Maybe if I use a different type of bean that was cooked longer and had more moisture to it, the plant would respond more favorably. Same thing with rice. Rather than using white rice, what would happen if I used thoroughly cooked brown rice instead? That's another experiment to work with in the future. As a reminder, while it's fun to feed your plant, it's completely unnecessary. Venus flytraps will catch bugs on their own. Bugs and broccoli are only a source of fertilizer for the plant, not a source of energy. Plants will get their energy from sunlight through photosynthesis. So you can feed your plant all the bugs and broccoli you want. If the plant is not getting enough sunlight, it will never be healthy. If you want to learn more about growing Venus flytraps and other carnivorous plants, visit our website at growcarnivorousplants.com. We have tons of information on that site to get you on the right track. So thank you for watching, and I'll meet up with you in another video.